It's Friday. It's Kevin. It's live from lockdown. Here we are. Thank you for joining me again. I can already see a few people commenting on there. No one sending me urgent texts or telling me there's a big problem, so I'm assuming I'm coming through. I better talk into the microphone. Sorry about that. My weekly live from lockdown. This is number 28. And again, I appreciate you joining me. I'd like to start, as I always do, by acknowledging that I sit on the traditional territory of the Wendat and Anishinaabeg Nations, the people of the Haudenosaunee Confederacy, the Mississaugas of Inuit, and the Métis Nation. And it is those First Nations and the people of those nations that have kept this land whole and sacred since time immemorial. And it's their enduring hospitality and generosity that makes it possible for the rest of us to live here. So thanks, especially to the First Nations of this land. And here's an hour of words and music, first and foremost dedicated to the spirit of justice and reconciliation with those peoples. Really happy to have you with me. That off the top was a tune called My Ship, which was a request from one of my faithful and regular requesters, a good friend, Sam Broverman, of whom I have often spoken. A generous, beautiful guy, fantastic singer, professor of statistics at the University of Toronto. Yeah, kind of a Renaissance man, Sam is. Who I know is not watching at the moment, but said he might catch later. He sent me a message to say he wasn't going to be able to join because he had a meeting. So, Sam, I hope your meeting's going well, and I hope you catch up later, and I hope that that version of My Ship met you with your exacting requests. It's not a tune that I really know, as you can probably tell. Sam pointed out, kind of fun, it was composed, I didn't realize this, by an interesting combination of Kurt Weill, a great German composer who moved to the United States after fleeing Nazi Germany in, I think, 1933, as lots of creative artistic people, and particularly Jewish people, needed to do at that time in order to be able to stay alive. And he wrote that in conjunction with Ira Gershwin, who's the lyricist brother of George Gershwin. The famous Gershwin brothers usually wrote together. I actually didn't know that they had worked on a show together. Kurt Weill and Ira Gershwin wrote a show called Lady in the Dark, and My Ship is from that score. So there's a fun little tune off the top. I should get rid of that loop, which I handily pre-recorded to help myself through the fairly challenging chord changes that tune presents. I hate to keep saying this, but I say it every week. You know, the second wave is here, looking like lockdown's going to last. So please keep your requests coming, and I will endeavor to keep playing them. I may mention this again, but live from lockdown may be a little unpredictable over the next little while. Things are going to be a bit nomadic. Stay tuned to my Facebook page, but I will keep paying attention to your requests and keep playing what I can as I can. Yeah. It's an interesting time of year in many ways, one of which is the light is really changing. I'm assuming that no matter where you are, I don't think I have any listeners who are not in the Northern Hemisphere, and certainly the light's changing. An hour ago, I was working on some stuff, and I couldn't see the lights on my pedals because of the light coming in that window, and it seems to be changing a bunch. So hopefully you can see things okay. My ship got me thinking about my boat, and particularly my little boat, and a beautiful bossa nova tune called El Barquinho, which means my little boat. My Portuguese isn't very good, as you know. That's a beautiful tune by Vince Mendoza, and I thought it might be fun to play my little boat as well as my ship on my show. And in particular, I want to send this out to two fabulous people, Bronwyn Brent and Mario Caribe. I've spoken of them before. If you're a regular listener, you will know Bronwyn Brent is a really, really great songwriter. I encourage you to check out her music online. I just realized I didn't put a link to her stuff on the notes on the Facebook page. I'll try to rectify that. Bronwyn's a great singer-songwriter, and the person that I was on tour with in the UK back in March when this pandemic got declared and our tour got cut short. So I have played a few live gigs since then, now and here and there, that I've talked about, but the last time I played two nights in a row live gigs was in March with Bronwyn Brent and Mario Caribe. Mario is a fantastic bass player who is Brazilian by birth and heritage, but lives near Edinburgh, and a really great musician. And I think it was his Brazilian influence that got Bronwyn singing My Little Boat. So Here's my attempt at Vince Mendoza's El Barquino. My Little Boat, El Barquino. There you go. Another tune that I clearly don't know. I'm reading those. It's been a crazy week. I'll say more about this in a minute, but I had the chance to be part of a really, really exciting, very cool online show yesterday with Stream Cycle, Mark Kearney's Stream Cycle. But it meant I spent all my time getting ready for that. I just got a message from my sister saying she can't find my show. Man. I'm going to text her. Excuse me for doing this. Oh, no. People are there. Look for the event on my page. I hope it works, because people are there. Yeah, people are listening. Sorry, folks. I shouldn't be doing that, sending texts while I'm trying to keep a show going. Anyway, it's my excuse this week. I often have an excuse for being underprepared for this show, and I'm underprepared again, playing tunes I don't really know. And that's why here's another one that I've never played solo before, but I'm going to try. I'm going to set up a loop and then a loop and see how I do. This is yet another request, and again, thank you for keeping those requests coming. While I'm on the subject of thank you for all of the support that you folks give me over all this time. If you have an income and you are able to support live music endeavors like this, you know that those of us who are trying to play live music for a living really appreciate it. And again, if you check the links on the side of the Facebook page, you will see links to my PayPal account and my Ko-fi account, and my email address is even here along the bottom of the screen. You can send me an Interac e-transfer if you're in Canada. No pressure. Mostly I want you to enjoy the music, but I'd be much obliged for the support if that's possible. So I mentioned a request. Here's another request from a regular supporter and requester and very good friend from way back, Judy Shand. And last week I played Doris Day. Well, I played Secret Love. Doris Day was the reference for Judy last week. And when she sent me the request for Secret Love, she also asked for this tune by Sting. Called Fragile. So here's Fragile. There you go, Fragile by Sting. Hope you like that. Judy, I hope that was okay for you. Keep the requests coming. I think I've done all your requests now. So it's great you keep sending them in. Please keep sending them in. I gotta figure out what I'm playing next and what guitar I need. Oh yeah, that's what's gonna happen next. Anyway, that was Fragile. So I mentioned this. I was part of this great show yesterday, and you know, if you have limited time for watching music on Facebook, I almost suggest you stop this right now when you go over to the Stream Cycle page. Stream Cycle is the brainchild of a genius, technical and musical genius by the name of Mike Kearney, an Irishman who lives in Edinburgh, who in Portobello, I believe. And Mike has developed this amazing way. I've spoken about this a few times. I've done a couple of these gigs. Sorry, speaking into the microphone. I've spoken about this a couple of times. Mike has developed this amazing way for musicians to play almost together online. By the time it gets to you, it's together, at least it should be. It involves some internet sorcery and some trust, as I often say, because we sort of line up in a row. We all start playing our parts of the song at different times so that they land at the right time at the end. It's really quite remarkable. And yesterday we did a Paul Simon tribute, and it was so much fun. Oh man, I love that music, and it was such an interesting thing to be part of, and such a great band. Mike Kearney, as I mentioned, puts it together, plays keyboards. He played a bit of trombone. He's a very talented guy. The front man on this particular Stream Cycle show was a guy named Stu Goodall, another Edinburgh resident, I think just outside Edinburgh. Stu's an amazing, amazing singer and guitar player. Man, he delivers those Paul Simon tunes with such elegance. Just gets Paul's phrasing. Yeah, really, really did a lovely job. He's one of those people, I learned this in the chat after the show, he's one of those people with an ear that can just hear musicians, because he did a Sting imitation that was absolutely hilarious. So if you ever have a chance to check out Stu Goodall, I know that Stu was part of a show called, I think, the Paul Simon Treatment. This happened at the Edinburgh Festival a couple of times, and I sure hope it comes back. And next time it comes back, I hope I get to be in the band. The musical director for that project was a guy named Mike Chisholm. Chiz, we call him, lives in London at the moment. Really another great musician, plays guitar and keyboards and a bunch of things, wrote a bunch of the charts, was a lot of help to me getting the music ready. Dougie Coulter on bass, C-Mac, Callum McIntyre on drums, Paddy Darley on trombone. That's some of the Stream Cycle regulars. And I got to tell you, what a great band. So I am going to play, am I going to do that now? I'm losing track of what's coming up. Sorry, Dave Lipsy, it's not quite mandolin time. I'm going to play a couple of Paul Simon tunes on my show today, as sort of a reference to that great show yesterday. And I'm going to play the first one on this guitar. Sorry for getting mixed up. As well as this being a Paul Simon tune and a reference to Stream Cycle on that show yesterday, it's also going to be a birthday dedication. Tanya Smith had a birthday this week. Tanya is a wonderful, wonderful woman who is the partner of my sister Ren, who was just texting me, but I think they must have found the show. I'm hoping they found the show. Oh, look at that. She got it. Good. I'm nice that Tanya's watching. Tanya, happy birthday again. I had the privilege of spending the weekend, part of the weekend last weekend, with Tanya and Ren and their fabulous children, Devin and Jet. Hello, Devin and Jet, if you're listening. And I texted Tanya this afternoon because I stupidly forgot to ask if she had any birthday requests. So this is just a good birthday song, if you ask me. Tanya's not that old, so it's really not the right one for her, but I hope she likes it. This is called Still Crazy After All These Years. I'll try to put that back. Thank you. Still crazy. Still crazy after all these years. Not so many years in Tanya's case, but very happy birthday to you, Tanya. Hope you're still celebrating. I got some really fantastic carrot cake as a result of that particular occasion last weekend. I gotta say, that carrot cake lasted well into Monday night, which was fantastic. And big thanks to Mike Kearney and Stu Goodall and Chiz and all the Stream Cycle gang. Maybe a bit more Paul Simon coming up before the end of the show, if we have time for that. That's the end of my morning coffee, because it's been a long day. So mandolin time. A reminder while I'm switching up, I made my plug for donations, which I always appreciate. If you want to get some of this music, I've also got lots of recordings available on Bandcamp. Again, if you check the links on the side of the Facebook page, or if you just go to Bandcamp and look for Kevin Barrett Group, you'll find a bunch of recordings and you'll find a bunch of great music. Daniel Barnes is a fantastic drummer here in Toronto who just emailed his list this week to say that he's now on Bandcamp. Really is the best platform. If you want to buy music online, CDs or digital downloads, and you want to actually support musicians, use Bandcamp. Don't go to Spotify. Don't go to Apple Music, ripping people off all the time. Go to Bandcamp because they actually care about music and musicians. They're really a fantastic organization. Right. I try to play a mandolin tune every week, try to get my head around this instrument. I keep complaining about what a busy week it is, so I didn't have time to do anything too elaborate, but I'm not repeating myself. I'm doing a tune I haven't played. This is a pretty simple one. Again, with a big nod to Fred Thompson and Catherine Nicol in Edinburgh, who have been encouraging me to explore the world of traditional tunes and to start with the hornpipes. Here's another hornpipe that Stuart Seidel sent me, although it's a well-known one. I think maybe it appears in the Popeye cartoon soundtrack sometimes, and appropriately for that, called the Sailor's Hornpipe. I hope you like it. Thank you. the pedal on the way out. Sorry about that. Anyway, there you go. The Sailor's Hornpipe. Thanks for your patience with my attempts to play the mandolin. Louise Bevan, I don't know if you're listening today, but Louise is always playing along, and I'm sure she had that one. She probably knows that one. So thank you. Ah, what fun. As I say, little shades of Popeye. I know I've heard that one before in my youth. Another one of my regular reminders that I'm doing a bit of teaching online, again, trying to keep hold of whatever little bits of work we can do while we're in lockdown. You'll want to learn a bit about playing the guitar. I only know a bit, but I can teach you that in a lesson or two. Hook me up. Again, I'm pretty easy to find. You can send me a message on Facebook. You can check my website and my email address and even my phone number along the bottom of the screen here. I'd love to talk to you about that. I've had a few new students come my way recently, and a few old students come back. Fern Langer, I don't know if you're listening today. Fern and Jack tuned into the Stream Cycle show yesterday, and Fern took a bunch of lessons with me about years or more ago, and has come back. It's been really nice to see her work on her guitar playing, which she's very passionate about. In the interest of honoring the Paul Simon experience yesterday, and also taking heed of those of you who tell me I should keep singing, I confessed to you last week that I actually like singing, even though it's not the thing I do the best. So I'm going to sing you a Paul Simon tune. Again, probably not a wise idea when the fabulous Stu Goodall sung this very tune yesterday. Again, go check that one on the Stream Cycle page. A link on my page to find it. But here's a great old Paul Simon tune that I used to sing years ago. I used to have a little kind of folky duo with a really great musician by the name of Don Quinlan, who I haven't seen in ages. And I know Don's had a rough couple of years, and I don't know if he's around, if there's any chance he's listening, but I have memories of playing this with Don. Remember what key I do this in. Stu did it in the key of A flat. I'm going to do it in the key of E, a whole major third lower. This is called Slip Sliding Away. Slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. You know the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. I know a man, he came from my hometown. He wore his passion for his woman like a thorny crown. He said, Dolores, I live in fear. My love for you is so overpowering, I'm afraid that sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. Well, I know a woman became a wife.
Still a woman though.
These are the very words she uses to describe her life. She says a good day ain't got no pain. She says a bad day is when I lie in bed and I think of things that I did. Slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. You know the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. Well, I know a father who had a son. He longed to tell him all the reasons for the things he'd done. He drove a long way
kissed his boy as he lay sleeping, and he turned around and headed home again. Slip sliding away, slip sliding away. You know the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away. Well, God only knows. God makes her plans. The information's unavailable to the mortal man. Work at our jobs, collect our pay. Believe we're gliding down the highway when in fact we're slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. Slip sliding away. You know the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding. The nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding. The nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away.
Slip sliding away. Thank you to Paul Simon. Got to be one of the greatest songwriters of our generation, I think. My generation. Some of you are younger than that, but ain't he great? Wow, look at that. Time's passing today. People still seem to be there. No one's sending me panic texts saying they can't hear me, so I'm happy about that because I'm near the end. Again, thank you for listening. Again, if you know... How was I going to do that? No, I was going to do that with this guitar first. Getting ready for my last tune. Which, as you know, if you're a regular watcher, you know that I play... I try to play an old tune from the pop world and build a loop and have a bit of an extravaganza at the end. But first of all, a message of love. First, before that, well, partially a message of love, because I love you and I so appreciate that you listen to this show. I said this earlier just to say that, you know, I might not be on every week. I think I'll be able to do this next week, but things may be a little unpredictable over the next few weeks, and I ask you to keep track of my Facebook page. Lots going on in my world. Second part of my weekly message of love now is please wear a mask and please reduce your contacts and keep your distance. Every day on the news, there's more and more places setting records for new numbers of COVID cases. I think France set a record yesterday. The province of Quebec in Canada is up over 1,000 daily cases again yesterday. We are in trouble, folks, and we're in trouble because we're not being careful, and we're letting that virus get away, get out of control, and we've got to stop. The premier of the province of Ontario just today announced increased lockdown measures in a bunch of the suburban areas outside of Toronto because the virus is spreading there. And I'm really scared about that. I'm scared for me and the people I love and you and all the people you love. And we got to be careful. So let's do that. And one other little part to my message of love, which is actually a quotation of which I was reminded this week. There's a lovely little park just up the street here in Kensington Market, where I am. And there's a little statue in that park of Al Waxman. Al was a famous and fabulous Canadian actor for many years, very well loved and very well known. And for a long time, he was the star of a television show, a series called The King of Kensington, and Al was himself the King of Kensington, a show set right in this very neighborhood, which is kind of a magical neighborhood, one of the most interesting and really diverse neighborhoods probably anywhere on the planet. So I'm so lucky to spend time here. And that statue, there's a statue of Al in the park with a little plaque on the ground that has a fabulous quote that's meant a lot to me recently. And I think about it a lot, and it's funny, I haven't really been thinking about it lately, and then I had a chat earlier this week with my very good friend Fred Thompson from Edinburgh, and he reminded me of this quote and how apropos it is these days. So I'm going to read you this, and then I'm going to do one more tune. Here's what Al had to say. Trust your gut instincts. There's a lot to do down the road. There's always more. In small matters, trust your mind. But in the important decisions of life, trust your heart. There you go. Some words from Al Waxman. So I'm going to close with a tune by Bob Marley. And this was another request from Vicky Saunders, who had a birthday a few weeks ago. I don't know if I've played many people's requests 3 weeks in a row. I might have just played Judy Shan's request 3 weeks in a row. And now this is the third week that Vicky is going to get a tune of hers. This is a tune by Bob Marley that's called Three Little Birds. But a lot of people don't know that. They think that it goes by the words of the chorus, and that's what Vicky called it. She called it. She said she loved Bob Marley's Don't Worry About a Thing. And there's another little message of love for all of you. Don't worry about a thing. Every little thing's going to be all right. Hard to believe that some days, but if we don't keep that spirit of hope alive, I don't know what we're going to do. So here we go. Going to take me a while to build this up. As you know, refill your drink if you need to. Come back, and I hope to see you next week. Thank you very much. Thank you. noise. Thanks for your patience with all of this. Thank you for listening. I miss you.